shifting with the four-speed automatic. That's third gear downshift. That's one of my favorite things about the 700 R4. You can shift it manually all in a row.
Yep. Okay, and poutine with extra cheese.
one of my favorite things about the 700R4. You can shift it manually all in a row. Can I get two extra large triple triple coffees?
And
a McDouble sandwich.
A McDouble?
Yep.
Okay.
And poutine with extra cheese. That's it. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Oh, do you have a tray? I like the way he was handling the coffee by the lid, touching the lid like that. Japanese cars. There is a Dodge Charger, two Dodge Chargers, but the rest of them are all Japanese. Like there's a Husky driving that Cadillac CTS or CTS-V, two-door CTS-V.
Drive-through only by law, because
because of the virus, people aren't allowed to congregate inside of the restaurant or whatever. But I stopped at McDonald's and they handed me the coffee. The young lad working there hands me the coffee like this, and he's got his thumb on my mouthpiece. I wasn't very happy about that. I just asked for a tray. I didn't give him a hard time. I'll probably go home and pour the coffee into a different cup. Coffee is life. Coffee is life. If the coronavirus is death, then maybe this is the cure. I don't know. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to put my mouth on this one and drink out of it. They say that 70 degrees, the coronavirus dies over 70 degrees. And I've never had a coffee under 90 degrees, I don't think. So it's usually nice and hot. The lid is even piping hot. So I'm not afraid of any viruses living on it, really. But the fact that he was wearing gloves tells me that he doesn't want to touch stuff. Maybe it's dirty money. And then he's using the same gloves to touch my coffee cup with. Or not just the coffee cup. If you hand me the coffee cup, that's fine. I understand. You're doing your job. But if you hold it by the lid with your dirty gloves, same gloves that you're handling dirty money with, I don't know. I don't know about that. I'm a mild germaphobe, and I was a mild germaphobe way before this, like long, long time ago. I sort of got over it a little bit. I'm not as bad as I used to be. I'm not as picky as about germs, but I never liked somebody coughing within 6 feet of me. I never liked that. Sneezing on me, whatever, touching door handles. I was always paranoid about that stuff. Not paranoid, but more like conscious. I was always conscious about germs and people coughing near me and catching flus and colds from other people, stuff like that. So I'm not as bad of a germaphobe as I used to be, but I am conscious about people touching my mouthpiece, or, you know, the lid is the mouthpiece. So I am conscious about it. I'm not really worried about it, but I am conscious. I am not concerned, but I am not worried, but I am aware. Something like that. Does that make sense? So the amount of people that die from the flu every year, or even the bird flu, like other types of coronavirus that have been around for years. I think the bird flu and H1N1, I think they are variants of the coronavirus, different types of coronavirus. And that stuff kills people every year. The flu kills old people every year. If you took the amount of people that died from the flu, like old people and, you know, people with weak immune systems, and if you like started keeping track, you might be just as amazed, just as startled over how many people. There's a lot of people on Earth. 7 billion, 7.5 billion people on Earth, something like that. People die every day, and people get sick every day, and people die from the flu every day. So I am concerned, or I am conscious, I am aware. But I'm not really, I'm not gonna worry myself to death. Have you ever heard that saying? Don't worry yourself to death, or, yeah, worry to death. It's true. Worry causes stress, and stress is bad for your health. And that's true. Those are facts. That's scientific facts. So I try not to worry too much, because worry is bad for you. All the big scary news. If they say stay home as much as possible, I will. I had to go out today. I had to get groceries. I got some toilet paper, which seems to be amazing, because this whole virus, people are buying toilet paper out sometimes I wonder about that too. But anyway, I'm not afraid to drink out of my Tim Hortons cup. And it was a nice drive. Nice drive today. I saw a gang of motorcycles. I saw a trike. I saw a small get together, small car show, small car meet. I saw a couple classic cars. I saw a Ferrari today, like a nice Ferrari. If I had to guess, I would say it was like a brand new Ferrari. And I played with augmented reality today too for the first time. Made a video of the Firebird, and I put a Lamborghini Aventador right beside it in augmented reality. So I might do more stuff like that. It's my first time playing with it today, but it seemed so easy. It just seemed like easy and cool and easy. So I'll probably do more stuff like that in the future.